Right, we've now moved into his bay where we're going to do his cross-lining paper. This is the wall we're going to work on. It's already been pre-stripped. It was papered before. We've stripped it to make it so as it's all ready to go. Why are we cross-lining is the first question we have to ask. Right, there's two reasons we cross-line. One, we want an even, porous surface on the background, because when we've got areas like this, what will happen is as the paste dries here, it will dry there a lot quicker. So as lining paper will prevent that happening for us. The other thing is, we're going across the wall. When we put as finished paper on, which will come in the next lessons, then we're going down the wall. At no time will the joints be pulling against each other. So that's the reason we're going to cross-line the walls. So we're going to now measure up for what we do need. The first thing we're going to do is take a roll of paper. We're going to put it on the wall. We're going to go one, two, and a strip. So I now know that all we need is two plus one strip. Yeah? So, I can use a tape measure. I can measure, and you will find that lining paper comes in at 22 inches in old money or 56 centimetres. It's slightly wider than your standard European roll of paper. So you could also, if you wanted to, think how many 56s do I need and do it that way. But I just prefer for ease, use my roll of lining paper, it's straightforward. Right, the next thing we're going to do is measure the length of what we need. Right, this is where we sometimes find a lot of people coming unstuck a little bit. So, this is what we don't want. And as you can see, it's clumsy, it doesn't look good, especially in front of a customer. You will 9 out of 10 times find that the floor is exactly the same distance. So the easiest way for us to do this, yeah, a lump floor, it's going nowhere. Yeah, it looks neat, it looks tidy. Yeah, we're looking at this, we've got 290 centimetres. So we know now that we need two strips at 290 centimetres. Now, personally, I would like to add 10 centimetres at each side of this. So we've got a bit of leeway. If the wall's out, we've got 10 centimetres at each side to play with. So we've got 200 and 90 plus 10 at each side. So two 10s is 20. So I'm going to want 3 metres, 10 centimetres. Yeah. So I've got two strips at 3 metres, 10 centimetres. Because I need a strip, I'm going to cut three lengths. So I'm going to cut three lengths at 3 metres, 10 centimetres. And we're going to go down to this dado rail. So we'll now go back to the board.